her down. Oh, the dogs are driving me crazy today. I thought I'd make some tea and have a sit down there.
Oh, great. Dr. Abrams, I hope I'm not
intruding. First of all, it is Connie. And secondly, I am thrilled with unexpected visitors. I mean, that's what makes life so wonderfully unpredictable. How about some tea?
Yes, thank you. Did Dean O'Brien mention anything about why I'm here?
He said he had a friend who needed help, and I said I'd be happy to.
It's about Gerald Dixon.
Now, there's a name I haven't heard for a long time.
So you do know him?
I knew him.
Were you friends?
Acquaintances. But since we were both graduate students, teaching assistants at the time, I guess you could say we were colleagues, too.
What was he like back then?
Smart.
Charming.
Condescending.
So there was nothing, I don't know, out of the ordinary about him?
I guess the polite way to say this is Gerald Dixon was more than a little friendly with some of the co-eds. Back then, that was considered a perk of the job, why half the men went into it. There was a student of his, can't remember her name. Anyway, she became so obsessed with Gerald, possessive. And when he made it clear to her that it was over between them, she was determined not to be ignored. Of course, back then, the rules were much more lax about things like that, obviously, than they are today. But still, a sexual relationship between a TA and his student was not looked upon too fondly.
What happened?
As far as I recall, there was supposed to be a hearing. But on the day the girl was supposed to testify, she never showed up.
Well, where was she?
No one knew. She was never seen again.
I'm sorry, she disappeared?
Into thin air.
And Gerald Dixon was never charged with anything.
Gerald Dixon agreed to leave Middlesex, and the university concluded its investigation.
What do you think happened to that girl?
I think Gerald Dixon wanted her gone. And people like Gerald Dixon usually get what they want.